जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जन बलाब गिरिवर धारी, गोपी जन बलाब गिरिवर धारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, यशोदनंदना ब्रज जन रंजना, यशोदनंदना ब्रज जन रंजना, यमुना तेरा बनचा, यमुना तीर बन चारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिधर धारी, गोपी जन बल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजना, यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजना, यशोदनंदन ब्रज जन रंजना, यमुना तेरा बन चारी, यमुना तेरा बन चारी, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Radha Madhava Radha Madhava Shirate Daya Radha Gopinata Radha Gopinata Shirate Radha Shama Sundara Radha Shama Sundara Jaya Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Krishna Balaram Jaya Krishna Balaram Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Jaya Gauranitai. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Prabhupada. Nitai go hari bo hari bo hari bo gora hari bo Nitai go hari bo hari bo hari bo hari bo
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishna Bhutale Shimati Gopal Krishna Goswami Kramani Prabhupada Shasai Chamya Prakash Vitira Cha Pacharan Kirvan Shari Vipati Nama Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale
Can it be a little bit warmer?
It's too cold. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Simate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Sarasvati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesa Sunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaya Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Juta Pada Kamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsa Se Rupam Sagra Jatam Sahagana Raghunatam Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sarvadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Si Visakan Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindo Dhina Bando Jagatpate Gopesa Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta
जन गौरंगे राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
Everyone is getting colds. Change of season. So please forgive me if sometimes I will be like coughing here. Hare Krishna.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Text 31.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Continue reading from the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Saman Bonam, chapter 47, the Song of the Bee. Text 31. आत्मा ज्ञानमया शुद्धो व्यतिरिक्तो गुणान्वया सुषुप्ति स्वप्न जग्रद्भिः माया पृथिवीर् इयते आत्मज्ञानमया शुद्धो व्यतिरिक्तो गुणान्वया सुषुप्ति स्वप्न जग्रद्ये माया पृथिवीर् इयते आत्मा ज्ञानमया शुद्धो व्यतिरिक्तो गुणान्वया सुषुप्ति स्वप्न जग्रद्भिः माया पृथिवीर् इयते Matajis. Atma
Gyana Maya Shudo Vyati Rito Gunan Vaya Sushupti Swapna Chagradhir vritti viriyate. Atma jnana maya shuddho. Vyatirikto gunanvaya. Susupti svapna jagradvir. Maya vritti viriyate.
Word for word meaning, translation and purport by the disciples of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Atma, the soul, jnanamaya, comprising transcendental knowledge, shuddha, pure, vyatirikta, separate. Aguna anvaya. Uninvolved. In the reactions of the material modes. Susupti. In deep sleep. Swapna. Ordinary sleep. Jagradbhihi. And waking consciousness, maya, of the material energy, vrittivi, by the functions, iyate, is perceived. Translation: being composed of pure consciousness or knowledge, the soul is distinct from everything material and is uninvolved in the entanglements of the modes of nature. We can perceive the soul through the three functions of material nature known as wakefulness, sleep, and deep sleep. Everyone, please repeat. Being composed of pure consciousness, or knowledge, the soul is distinct from everything material and is uninvolved in the entanglements of the modes of nature. We can perceive the soul through the three functions of material nature known as wakefulness, sleep, and deep sleep. Purport. It is clearly stated here that the soul, Atma, is constituted of pure knowledge, pure consciousness, and is thus ontologically distinct from the material nature. Srila Vishwanath Chakrabarti points out that the word Atma may also be taken to mean, quote, the Supreme Soul, Lord Krishna, unquote. Since the Lord has just explained in the previous verses that all material phenomena are expansions of Himself, the phrase maya vrittibhir iyate indicates that by studying this world deeply, we will come to the perception of God. From this point of view also, the gopis were advised not to lament. Atma jnana maya shuddho vyatirikto gunanvaya susupti svapna jagradbhir maya prithivir iyate. So now the message coming from Lord Krishna through Uddhava, his messenger, is now being delivered. Previous to this verse, around two or three verses, the Supreme Lord's message now is being read to the gopis. The song of the B is very, very intimate, very intricate, very difficult to understand for the conditioned souls. Specifically, how can a bee talk and a person can hear and listen, and also as if they are talking with each other. This could be done especially for those who are crazy or mad in this world. They talk to themselves, or sometimes they will talk to somebody or something imaginary. In the case of the gopi being mentioned here, who has been talking to the bee, Sukadev Goswami, the name of the gopi was not mentioned. Actually, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, no gopi's name were mentioned except Mother Yasoda or Rohini. Other gopis, what to say of Srimati Radharani? To say the word or the name of Srimati Radharani, the Acharyas mentions that if he says the name of Srimati Radharani, then he will fall into ecstasy. He'll become unconscious. And therefore, how are we going to hear the remaining part of the Srimad Bhagavatam? It is not possible. We'll just stop anywhere when the name of Radharani is being supposed to be mentioned. But here it just says the gopis, or the gopi says, so that the Srimad Bhagavatam will be continuously narrated by Srila Sukadev Goswami to Parikshit Maharaj. Similarly, the Srimad Bhagavatam will not have been spoken if Parikshit Maharaj was not cursed by Sringi, that Brahmana boy who heard while playing with his Brahmana friends that the king put around the shoulder or the neck of his father Samika Rishi while having his deep meditation a dead snake. It says there that Parikshit Maharaj is a pure devotee of the Supreme Lord. It is not ordinary. Somehow, Krishna's arrangement that he became thirsty, he became hangry, he became tired, and usually a pure devotee of the Lord can tolerate all of this. But somehow, while hunting, Parikshit Maharaj was put into that situation. And when he entered the ashram, the hermitage of Samika Rishi, Samika Rishi was not able to entertain and greet him properly, being the king. And out of anger, again, a pure devotee of the Lord is supposed to be not to be angry, but sometimes they become angry, not for themselves, but for others. Especially if a devotee or a Vaishnava is being blasphemed or criticized, or the Supreme Lord is being criticized. And therefore, that's why we have the Srimad Bhagavatam. And here in this part, Uddhava is a Jnani Bhakta. He's a disciple of Brihaspati. Brihaspati being the demigod's priest, and he's very knowledgeable, well versed in the Vedas. So similarly, the position of Uddhava is like this, following in the footsteps of his spiritual master. And he was the best representative of Lord Krishna because he resembled exactly the same like that of Lord Krishna, that when the inhabitants of Vrindavan, when he first arrived in Vrindavan coming from Mathura, wearing the same color of dhoti, the same exactly color of Lord Krishna, bluish black or blackish blue, They thought that Krishna has returned. Lord Krishna sent Uddhava to Vrindavan to see the extent of love, the prem, the love of the Brajabasis, which is beyond jnana and karma. Being a jnani bhakti, or jnana bhakti, or bhakta, he can only reach up to a certain level. He does not have any indication or clue what is Braja Prem. So when he came and the interaction that he had with the Brajabasis, he can see that how much love they have for Lord Krishna. It is not of this world. It cannot compare to anything else in this world. And they were all feeling separation when he first arrived, as if they are like dead. Their clothes were disheveled. They forgot to put on their saris properly. They forgot even to eat. They're all very, very in morose position, in lamentation. Only those who are feeling separation with Lord Krishna can have this experience and feelings. And maybe some of you are. But most of us who are still in the sadhana, Vaidhi sadhana platform, we don't have that feelings of separation to Lord Krishna. Because as Prabhupada says, if we have that feeling of separation towards Lord Krishna, we will be dead by now. We will not have anything to live for. But because we don't have that experience of love and separation from Lord Krishna, and that's why we're still living. And some of you may have that experience even with your family. If you're not with your family for a long time, you're also always thinking of your family members. For the husband, always thinking of the wife. For the wife, always thinking of the husband. Or for the father and mother, always thinking of the children. Not necessarily always the children thinking of the parents. This is the conditioned state. But for the Brajabasis, in the wakefulness, in the sleeping state, and in the dream state, they are thinking of Krishna, his spurti, his transcendental form, Shama Sundar form, not the Paramatma. Krishna, when he sent the message to the gopis, especially to Srimati Radharani, there is a hidden meaning, not direct. In the beginning, he's like telling them in the jnana platform, just to have them more experience the love that he has towards them. Sometimes, you know, when you have a loved one and you want to send something, some message, there is like an indirect message. Not direct, but only the receiver of the message can understand the meaning or the conclusion later on. So he's giving a hint. And in this verse, Krishna was saying that he is Atmajnana Maya. Atmajnana Shuddho. He is the soul comprising of transcendental knowledge, pure in its condition, eternal condition, pure. So, Atma, as Prabhupada says, can have two meanings. Param Atma and Atma. Paramatma means one of the three aspects of the Supreme Lord. Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavan iti sabjate. Badanti tat tatva vidas tatvam, yad jnanam advayam. Param Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavan iti sabjate. This is from the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. The first teachings that we've learned is that Krishna has three aspects: Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. According to one's advancement or conditioning, one realizes the Supreme Lord in these three aspects. One who is in the bodily platform, the impersonalist, not even in the bodily platform, less than the bodily platform, they consider the Supreme Lord as Brahman or Brahmajyoti or light that they want to merge. For the yogis, their meditation is that of the Paramatma, one who resides within one's heart and who is present everywhere, in every nook and corner of the material creation. In the second canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Paramatma, the way how to meditate the Paramatma, according to Sukadev Goswami, is that one meditates Paramatma within one's heart. And he is 8 inches long. How can that be? Again, sometimes the Paramatma, the size is compared to the thumb, the size from here to that end. And again, Paramatma is within every atom. So how can that be? He can be the smallest than the smaller, or smaller than the smallest, and bigger than the biggest. Paramatma is present within everyone's heart, and he fulfills everyone's desires. He is impartial. He is impartial in such a way that he provides the results of one's own fruitive activities, karma pala. This way he is impartial. At the same time, he is partial. He is partial. He favors more of his devotees. Even though he kills the demons, and to give them punishment, actually it is also a reward. To kill demons, that means they also attain Svayujya Mukti. As we've heard from Shishupal, Dantavakra, of course they are Jai and Vijay. First Svayujya Mukti, and then eventually Sarupya Mukti. And what to say of the devotees of the Lord? Paramatma favors the devotees. He gives them pure love of God. For the devotees, they meditate on the Bhagavan feature of the Supreme Lord. And the gopis, their meditation is always the Shama Sundar form. In the Paramatma feature, there is no relationship. There is no rasa. Only in rasa, one can have happiness. Because in rasa, there are activities. When there are activities, there is a relationship. When there is a relationship, there is satisfaction. When there is satisfaction, there is happiness. So, the gopis, in their wakefulness, they're thinking of Krishna. 24 hours. Not a single moment will be there that they will not be thinking of Krishna, that they will even curse Lord Brahma for somehow an imperfect creator, making them to blink their eyes even for a moment. And without one moment or less than a moment of blinking of the eyes, they will not be able to see Krishna. But they will see Krishna within their mind. They may not see Krishna face to face, but they will see Krishna within their mind, within their senses, within their life airs. We within their intelligence. These are the gopis. In their sleep, they also see Krishna. Sometimes the gopis will even talk of his names while sleeping. I know some devotees, they chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra while sleeping. That is good. That means the whole day, they are saturated with Krishna consciousness. They're always making plans, always trying to make a way how to always give pleasure to Krishna. The result of the whole day's activities is reflected when we sleep. Sometimes, you know, a conditioned soul will talk nonsense, garbage. Not sometimes. Most of the times. Or all the times. While sleeping. But the devotees of the Lord, they will also talk of Krishna. Or the gopis will talk of Krishna. And even in the deep sleep, you know what's deep sleep? I have this Apple Watch I use to sleep when you're sleeping to see how many hours I slept. And in there, some of you have Apple Watch, right? And it will say there, core sleep. It says there also REM, rapid eye movement. That means while we're sleeping, our eyes are moving also. Maybe not opening, but it is moving inside. And there is a deep sleep. In deep sleep, you don't think of anything else. You don't know what's going on. Even though, conscious-wise, we are present. But we don't know. But this is a very small amount during the whole night of sleep, the deep sleep. But the gopis, even in deep sleep, which is supposed to be you're not thinking of anything, you're not remembering of anything, still they're seeing Krishna. In Shyamasundar form. So, the nature of the gopis are the best. That's why Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told us to follow in their footsteps. Especially, we can achieve this by following the instructions coming from the spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada, the previous acharyas, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, that it is easy to remember Krishna. When Srila Prabhupada says that surrender unto me, he says there is no difference between Lord Krishna's teachings. Surrender unto me in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarva Dharman Parichaja, and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction to always chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we will be able to attain love of God. There is no difference. So the super soul is there. He is our well-wisher, ever well-wisher. He is our best friend. And he's giving us independence. Minute independence, specifically. Not independence that you can do anything that you like and you will not be culpable for the reaction. When Prabhupada says, if we want to forget Krishna, Krishna will make sure that we will forget him forever. And then on the other hand, if we want to remember Krishna, and Paramatma understood our desire to be in that way, then Paramatma will give all the facilities, everything we need to remember him all the time. So there are two kinds of Atma, Jiva Atma. One kind of Jiva Atma, according to Patanjali, is that one who is detached from material things. One who is detached from material things. And another kind of Atma is one who is detached from material things. Attached from material things and detached from material things. So where are we? We should measure ourselves. Where am I right now? Am I 50-50? Still attached to many things, but I still want Krishna? But we cannot be like that forever, 50-50. We have to choose either one. At least 51% towards Krishna. And if we are in that category, then Krishna will make further, more and more facilities from which we can get closer and closer unto Him. So Lord Krishna is beyond the gunas. And as long as we are under the modes of material nature, then it is very difficult to attain Him. To attain the most pure, we have to be pure. And therefore, we have to work on our anarthas. The anarthas are the stumbling blocks of our advancement, making advancement in Krishna consciousness. The gopis, they don't have any more anarthas. And they are so in elevated position that they can chastise Krishna. Now, we cannot chastise Krishna. Out of love, one can chastise another one. A friend can chastise another friend out of love. But somehow, the gopis, they have more, much more to offer to Lord Krishna. We've heard the other day one devotee was saying, the gopis, they never want Krishna alone for themselves. They want Krishna for Radharani. This is their mood. They're pushing each other. So we have to also understand in such a way, am my mood is I want only Krishna for myself, or am I also willing to give Krishna to others? That's why Srila Prabhupada says book distribution is compared to rasa dance. Because the book distributor is always thinking of Krishna. They breathe Krishna in the form of the books. They always think of Krishna. They eat, always thinking of Krishna. The whole day, their meditation is Krishna. How to give Krishna to others in the form of books. Or a Sankirtan devotee. Because Nama Sankirtan is not just only performing chanting of the holy name of the Lord. Also, reading Srimad Bhagavatam is Nama Sankirtan. Or doing Aartik for the Lord, that is also Nama Sankirtan. Or doing some other seemingly mundane work. It's like here we have accounts office. It's called Prabhupada's accounts office. Because everything there, the meditation is, this is for Krishna. This is not for me. Everything that's going on in the temple, Krishna is the center. And therefore, everyone is supposed to be in that meditation, just like of the gopis. They understand everything belongs to Krishna. Paramatma means He is the proprietor of everything. Sarvaloka Maheshwaram, Voktaram Yagyatapasam, Sarvaloka Maheshwaram, Suridam Sarvabhutanam, Gyatvamam Shantim Richati. A devotee of the Supreme Lord, he knows nothing belongs to him. Everything belongs to Krishna. I will give anything and everything for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord, which means I will sacrifice even my very self, just like the gopis. So in this verse, this is the way how we can understand. There's a deeper meaning of this, that I'm always with you. Lord Krishna told to the gopis. Because Krishna is the soul of their soul. Our soul, the deeper is that the soul is that Krishna is still present within our soul because he's present everywhere. And the gopis, they have this understanding that without Krishna, life is useless. I will not be able to exist. From this point of view, also the gopis were advised not to lament. The gopis' lamentation is unbearable to see. That Uddhava, when he first came, he understood that the gopis, they have the highest love for Krishna. And that's why it says also, Rupa Goswami says that prem is higher than Krishna. Even though Krishna is the highest, he is the greatest, but the love of his devotees is greater than Krishna. Another point about Paramatma. Paramatma will give you a choice. You want to be with Krishna? You don't want to be with Krishna? That's fine. But the devotee of the Lord is better than Krishna. Because out of their love for Krishna, the devotees of the Lord, they don't give you any chance. They don't give you any choice. They only give you Krishna. The devotees of the Lord, they don't say, oh, it's okay, whatever you like. No, it's not like Paramatma. When the devotee of the Supreme Lord, he will speak, he will only speak about how to surrender to Krishna, how to give up everything for Krishna, how to chant Hare Krishna. He will not say, oh, if you want to worship the demigods, okay, no, go ahead. I'll give you blessings. You worship the demigods. No. So here, we will be able to understand and perceive the presence of the Lord through Paramatma. Right now, we don't have that clear understanding of the Bhagavan feature, except when we see the Archavigraha form of the Supreme Lord. I'll stop here. Hare Krishna. Any questions or comment? Yes, Karbajanji. Even though the gopis are always thinking of Krishna, even though he is in Mathura, Lord Krishna is also always thinking of them. It says in the scriptures that within the heart of Lord Krishna, the devotees reside. And within the heart or the hearts of the devotees, Lord Krishna resides reciprocally. So it is not just the gopis are always thinking of Krishna, but Krishna also are always thinking of the gopis. The modes of material nature.
Yeah. Keeping on disturbing us.
Huh?
Yeah, keeping on disturbing us.
They keep on disturbing us. She's doing a good job.
So if you think about Krishna, this modes of material natures are pure and they are disturbing us. And we think about Krishna.
Yeah, and you're thinking of Krishna and the gunas are disturbing you. So what to do? Ignore. Go beyond the modes of material nature. The Prabhupada says, at least come to the platform of mode of goodness. What we're doing, the sadhana that we're doing, this is mode of goodness. It is not spiritual yet because our mind is not there. When we chant, it is transcendental, the chanting, but how we chant is not transcendental. Because we're thinking of something else besides the sound vibration of the Supreme Lord. Prabhupada says, ignore the mind. Mind is very tricky. I was hearing the Bajahure Mana song by Srila Prabhupada this morning. We should take shelter. The mind will not spare you. He will only give up the tricky part when the mind is convinced that you are a devotee of the Supreme Lord. And when you are surrendered unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, who is the only shelter, he's our only shelter. If the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord give shelter to the entire material world, spiritual world, who are we? Not even this size. You cannot even see the soul. Very minute. If we take shelter unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, then abhaya charanara vindare. There is no more fear. No more fear. Now we're always fearful. Huh? Why? Because we don't have that complete faith on Lord Krishna and his pure devotee. So gunas, they'll be washed. They'll be like, even liberation. It says liberation is waiting there to serve you. For a devotee, he doesn't need all of this. Even liberation. So gunas is there for the conditioned souls. It only works in Maya Shakti. But in Swarup Shakti, when you have that relationship with Lord Krishna, no more guna. Preetu Prabhu, please give them the please run. Of what?
Since you touched on the subject of sleep.
Sleep. Yeah, jeev jago.
So there's three stages, wakefulness, and then there's dream state,
deep sleep. Yeah. In the deep sleep, the soul is what?
The soul sleeps actually in deep sleep on the quote-unquote bed of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Mm-hmm.
And the comment is, that's why we feel refreshed after deep sleep. It can be charged. So I find this so amazing that this is not just for human beings. Every living being sleeps in deep sleep, is existing on the bed of the Supreme Personality of God. What that means, we don't know. But that's what Shastra says.
If I may say something, if that is the case, but because we are unconscious, we are not Krishna conscious, so we are not realizing that in the deep sleep, we are sleeping in the bed of Lord Krishna. But the gopis are fully conscious, whether they are in deep sleep or dream state and wakefulness. What? Huh? Well, most of us are always in the deep sleep and we don't know what's going on. That is the problem here. As Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Jeep Jago. Kota Nidra Jao Maya Pisa Chira Kole. Chant Gora Chandra's name. Yes, Shudi Prabhu?
It was good explanation you were giving with the mind. It reminds me of Krishna says in the sixth chapter of Bhagavad Gita that wherever the mind wanders, we should pull it back under the control of the self. But I wonder with this deep sleep, like sometimes I go to sleep listening to lectures in Prabhupada, does that help us get to deep sleep better, or being totally quiet gets us there better? Have you done some experiments with this?
There is an experiment done in South India, in the Gurukul. The two sets of students. One set of students, they were hearing some lectures about language. This group, they remember more than those who did not hear the lectures. They rapidly absorb the teachings. So even while we're asleep, I know some devotees, they have the Maha Mantra of Srila Prabhupada, keep going. Sometimes I will also have Prabhupada's lectures going on during the whole night. And I may fall asleep and I may not hear, but the subtle body is hearing this. The consciousness is hearing this. I may not hear with my ears, but the subconscious is hearing this and it is absorbing this. So it is a good practice if you can sleep with Maha Mantra of Srila Prabhupada or the lectures, rather than, you know, nothing at all. More likely one will dream of something else if you are not hearing transcendental sound vibration.
I was dreaming that these people were talking some real distinct Bhagavad Gita philosophy, but it was because I was hearing what Prabhupada was saying and I was imagining that he was speaking.
Yeah.
Wow, this is like directly what Prabhupada was saying. Of course he was saying that in the dream the people were talking.
Good. Any other points here? Yes, before we go to the Mataji. Give one first, you're closer. Shuddhi Prabhu? Yeah, right here. And give it to him and then to the back.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. My question is like, gopis were feeling the separation of Krishna every 24 hours. And I don't even feel for a second the separation of Krishna. Where do I know it now and how should I
I don't say that what you're doing is wrong. You're doing wrong. It's just you're not eager enough to see Krishna. Prabhupada says, if you really want to see Krishna, one should be so eager to see Krishna. And we're not that eager yet. We are on the process, but we should be greedy, actually, as Lolyam, Rupa Goswami says. We don't have that much greed yet to be with Krishna. That's why we are not having Krishna.
How old is that?
Then you have to be greedy. Greedy for service. Always chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, even without your japa mala. You can chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra wherever you are. Any time, any place, any circumstance. Some devotees say, oh, I don't have my japa mala with me, I cannot chant. No. You can chant even with your japa mala. The japa mala is there to count because we are having this agreement at the time of initiation that we have to chant minimum 16 rounds. But you don't need your mala to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Okay? Okay, last two questions there.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Bo.
My doubt is Maya ka prabhav naam mein reh sakta hai kya reh sakta hai naam mein koi bhakt logi the
rakhe. Hold on, I cannot. Hare Krishna. Just one second. Fast. Don't wait for 10 seconds. Yes, sir. What?
Maya can show her effect in the dham.
Yeah. Maya is everywhere. Even in the Holy Dham. Yes. But Maya is having these two faces. The Maya Shakti, and there is also the Yoga Maya. If you are pure in your heart, then you will not see the Maya effect, that Maya Shakti. If you are pure in your heart, But because we are impure, then we see, oh, this is dirty, it's smelly outside, too many people. In Vrindavan, Maya is present. You ask any rikshawala, a rikshawala will ask you, Prabhuji, do you want gambling? I know where a place you can do gambling. You want prostitution? I know a place where you can get prostitute. Huh? Even in Vrindavan? It's present here, but do you want that? So, you will not see that. Okay? So be very careful. There's a lot of thieves here taking advantage of Vrindavan. The real Vrindavan is aprakat right now. The other night, one thief was murdered near our ashram, right in the middle of the night. That's Maya. That's Maya. Fighting?
Fighting between some devotees.
Oh, no, right now they're fighting because of false ego.
False ego.
They may be having some argument, just like in our GBCs. They're not really fighting. They just want to find the best possible way how to serve Lord Krishna. They may have some argument presenting the better solution. But after the meeting, they're all friends. In the conditioned state, oh no. Out of false ego, they fight. Not verbally, but also physically.
As per natural instruction, Radhakund is the utmost place. But in Radhakund also, fighting between those, I have seen two devotees face. I have bewildered and what is this?
Don't worry about it. Chant Hare Krishna more Hare Krishna. You should see the deities instead of, you know, all of this. It's okay. Don't worry about those things. Mataji. You have any concluding words? That is a good point. That deep sleep, we all merge into the body of Mahavishnu. But we don't have a clue. We don't have any idea that we are with Mahavishnu. Is that, Maharaj? We are there. We are in the bed or inside Mahavishnu, who is all pure. But because of our conditioned state, we don't have any clue and no idea, no consciousness at all, knowingly that we are with Mahavishnu. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki. Waking up ki. In Krishna consciousness ki. Nitai Gaur Sitana Premanandi Hari Hari Bol.